So here we have an app called eXPr. We call it in Italian for expire. Okay, this is how our app looks like. It's built for the mobile. Let me show you the home page. It looks beautiful, so I can't miss it out. This is our home page. Okay, now we're gonna log in. Paste. Alright, so let's sign in as a user. There we go. So this is the summary page. So I can see there are two groceries and one has already expired. Right, and here you can check all your groceries. So wait, let's show you something very interesting. Let's go add new entry. Okay, so I'm going to add an entry. Like, you obviously will be able to add it manually. Let's try something interesting. Let's go for voice engine. Strawberries expiring tomorrow. There we go. You can see strawberries is expiring tomorrow because today is actually the 28th. Okay, let's submit this. Okay, now I want to create, let's try something, create another entry, something with an OCR technology. So I'm going to say the grocery because we've got to demonstrate that. Let's try banana. Right, so banana is only there. It doesn't, because I didn't say anything about the expiry date. Let's go for an expiry date. So obviously, you know, bananas don't come on expiry dates on papers like this, but for the sake of presentation, we'll just show you how it works. So there we go, we're gonna take the date and hopefully, yep, you can see the date is parsed out there. So we are using here an OCR technology and voice technology to assist users to help get their apps. It's a good user experience, I see. So that's December 12th, sorry, that's May of 12th, 12th of May, so you can see here. Let's submit that. So you can see, here are all the expired groceries and these are not expired. So now I want to find out if there are any recipes I can cook with all these things. So let's try, maybe I just want to cook something with banana. Let's try banana. Create recipes. Yep, there we go. We have banana crumbs and Nikki, and we can actually click this link to like bring it to another website to see what are the kind of recipes you can cook. So give it some time. Should open up page. There we go. So you can actually look up on the recipe and like how it's being done and stuff like that. So this is a pretty cool technology that we've implemented for the user as well. Finally, this is the gem of our app. Let's show you something interesting. You might see this small little button over here. Now what's that, I wonder? Add strawberries expiring in 3 days. There we go. So in 3 days, that's the 1st of December. So this is the power of our app. So we are able to use completely voice to do many, many different things. I'm going to submit this. I know we have so many strawberries. So let's find out. Let's see anything expiring within 3 days. Okay, let's try. Show all expiring in 3 days. There we go. We see that strawberries are expiring in 3 days and it shows the number of days left. So this is eXPr. Okay, one final feature we have is actually, because this is a web app, obviously you expect like, how is the app going to tell me what is expiring in 3 days? Well, let's show you that. For the sake of this demo, I'm going to show you like, okay, look at notifications. You can see, be notified of expiring groceries within how many days. So like, I want to find out groceries expiring like in 5 days. Let's try that, submit. Right, another notification has actually came in. See that, there we go. The eXPr web app says you have 2 groceries expiring in 5 days. So this is our app. So there we go. Thank you.